bow down before the one you serve. You're going to get what you deserve. Bow down before the one you serve. You're going to get what you deserve.
Hello and welcome to the Skip Ace Fantasy Disc Golf Podcast. I threw you for a loop there with some Nine Inch Nails, not my normal indie emo music, but the lead singer, Trent Reznor, grew up in Iowa until he was like in high school. Then he moved to Cleveland. Then I think he went out to LA, formed Nine Inch Nails, all that other good stuff that Nine Inch Nails is known for. But you know what? Now you know, and knowing is half the battle. And this week, we are moving to Iowa, Des Moines to be exact. The Des Moines Challenge is one of our newer events on the DGPT, only being around for 2 years prior to this. The course is really renowned for its kind of park-style golf, harkening back to kind of some days of yore back in the 2000s. And you're gonna love my DMC picks, maybe. We'll see. This event wasn't really well attended the first year, so a lot of players only have about 1 year of practice on this course. Some of them are going into the 2 years of practice. But last year, Simon won this event. It was right in the middle of his great 2022 run. Honestly, if you're going to look at an MPO player, it can't hurt to have Simon on your team. It's a little bit risky. He's been a little touch and go this season, but overall he's having a solid year. I don't know if he's going to have the same kind of push that he had last year, but like with most courses, distance doesn't hurt. One of the other players I'm really looking at in MPO is Kevin Jones this week. And I know we haven't really talked a lot about him this year, but rumor has it he's kind of found that spark again. And it also doesn't really hurt that he's averaged fifth place here the last 2 years. Get Kevin Jones on your team if you can afford him. If you're looking for a little bit more bang for your buck, Bobby B. Most people call him Robert Burridge. He pushed Simon to a playoff last year. He's only rated 1022. If you want someone a little bit more established than Bobby B, look at Emerson Keith, who's really only rated 1020 right now and averaged sixth place here over the last 2 years. I do have a high risk, kind of low reward player to pick. It's Paul Ulibarri. This is an old school course, as I said, and he's an old school player. He's finished top 20 here the past 2 years. I wouldn't necessarily anchor my team with him, but if you've got around 1,015, 1,016 ratings points you want to spare, I think he would be a very consistent pick. But the Des Moines Challenge hasn't really been nice to all the MPO players over the last few years. One of our big stars this season, Isaac Robinson, actually took 29th here last year. I expect him to finish a little bit better this year, but being as high-priced as he is right now, honestly, I would avoid him. The other high-priced player I would avoid is Aaron Gossage. I don't know if it's the course, if it's his game at this course, but he averaged 48th place here over the last 2 years, not just a fluke. So I just can't put him on my team with that type of history out here. Let's talk about the FPO players. Can Tatar finally make this the first year-over-year win? She's had a lot of wins, but she can't seem to back up a win with another win year-over-year. I wouldn't bet against her here. She played really well. It seems to be a really solid course for her. But if you need a strong FPO player, Tatar, Pierce, or even maybe Gannon. Missy Gannon could be the ones, and you're going to pay for them. Some of the lower-priced FPO players that I think you could really look at here at the Des Moines Challenge. The riskiest one would be Erica Stinchcomb. Now, she finished fifth here last year. She's only rated 927, but being rated 927 comes with some, we'll say, variety. You might get 20th out of her. You might get 5th. A less risky pick would be Macy Velez-Diaz. Macy finished 3rd here last year, is rated right around 959. She's a good middle-of-the-road pick. The same can be said about Jessica Weiss. Kind of like Yuli in the MPO, she's more of an old school player with an old school type of throw on this old school course. She's rated 956. I wouldn't have a problem starting her if I had those type of ratings points to play with. The FPO players that I would not look at this week, Lisa Fakus and Maria Oliva. Neither have played particularly well here in the past. And the same can be said about last week's winner, Haley King. Haley played awful here last year. And while I wouldn't put a bet against Haley personally, this does have all the setup for a big letdown week after her big week in Emporia. Now, there's a few players here, as I said, that haven't played before. Jen Allen, Ella Hansen, Caroline Henderson over on the FPO side. And on the MPO side, Eagle McMahon. Now, again, personally, I'd avoid Eagle like the plague right now. You just don't know if he's even going to play. You don't know how he's going to play with his injury. I have not heard one way or the other right now. And last week's winner, as everybody knows, Peter Welk, the most famous guy in disc golf right now. He's playing really well. He's only rated 1,010, but he hasn't played this course before. And if you listen to his interview with Terry Miller, he said that was one of his weaknesses, not knowing the courses. When he gets to know the course, he plays better. He played dynamic discs last year. He did not play the Des Moines Challenge. So he might be the hot hand, but I think he is a risky pick over here. And let's go back a week and look at my DDO review picks. I said that the safe picks were Ricky, Gossage, Tatar, and Cat. And all of them ended up being safe picks. If you spent your ratings points on them, you weren't disappointed. Now my riskier sleeper picks in MPO were Gavin Rathbun, Colton Montgomery, and Thomas Gilbert. Gavin, he came through 12th place, tied with Aaron Gossage. Colton, unfortunately, kind of crapped out and finished in 75th. Gilbert, right in the middle, took 30th. Not bad for his ratings, but I was hoping for a better finish from him. And the MPO players I told you to absolutely avoid last week were Chris Clemens and Double G, and both of them finished in 50th place, well below their ratings per point ratio. So hopefully you listened to me there and stayed far, far away from those guys. And over on the FPO side, my riskier picks were Madison Walker and Vanessa Van Dyken. Walker was a solid 18th place, but Van Dyken was two strokes better, finishing inside the top 15. Not bad if you grabbed them. Better for Van Dyken. And last week I told you to avoid Aria Castorina, Stacey Ronsley, and Missy Gannon. And out of those three, Aria was really the only one that I hit correctly. Aria did not finish well. The other two actually finished pretty good. So you win some, you lose some. Let's talk about draft leagues real quick. Last week, I said get Ezra Robinson. I hope you listened, because Ezra Robinson finished top 10. So if you had him on your team, you looked like a genius. Now this week, I'm looking at players who are owned, again, in less than about 65% of leagues. So someone who might be out there in some deeper leagues. I don't know how Evan Smith is available in 45% of leagues right now. He's 1030 rated, and he took third here last year. Now look, if he's available, don't just get him. Start him this week. If I have to log on to your account and pick him up and drop someone like Paul McBeth for him, I'll do that. Don't threaten me. The other person you should probably pick up is maybe Hannah Wynn. It's a little bit lighter in FPO this week. I'm going on a little bit of a stretch with Hannah. She's never played here before, but she's really only owned in 32% of leagues, probably about where she should be owned, to be honest. I just got a gut feeling that Hannah's going to have a good week. So take a look for Hannah Wynn. Now, if you want to see all my data, all the statistics for the last 2 years at the DMC, you can go to skipbase.com/DMCpast. And again, exclusive place where I share this. I don't share it anywhere else. And I want to give a big shout out to this week's sponsor for our Des Moines Challenge Skip Base Pro Only event matchup. It's Clash Discs. And you know the deal with Clash Discs. They've got all the flavors of disc you could ever want. They're giving away 4 discs this week. So an entire package of plastic. We'll ship it right to your door. For $10, you can sign up to be a premium member of Skip Base and have access to our weekly giveaways. Once again, that's skipbase.com/pro. And thanks for listening. I will talk to you again next week before our next Elite event. We've got 3 Elite events in a row. DMC, Preserve, and Idlewild? Jeez. We're going to get sick of disc golf. Anyway, once again, this is Johnny V. Thanks for listening. I will talk to you again in St. Cloud, Minnesota.